guys, and welcome back one last time. This is the last video I will make today, but I hope you rewatch some of the videos on YouTube. And for the very last time, we need to sing our Hello There song. My turn first. Hello there, how are you? It's so good to see you. We'll sing and be happy. We're all here together again. Great. It's been so nice learning with you in this format through our screens, especially right now when we have to be further apart to stay safe. But today we have two really exciting read alouds. We will end with Oh, the Places You'll Go, because I thought this was a wonderful way to wrap up our time together. And I also have a great read aloud called Dear Primo, and we're going to start with Dear Primo right now. All right, friends, here we go with our book. It's called Dear Primo, A Letter to My Cousin. The author and illustrator, his name is Duncan Donadillo. I think these are really cool illustrations. I think you'll like it. The dedication from the author says, to everyone trying to make a new home away from their home, and special thanks to Julia Gorton for opening this door. Let's get started. Score! I just got a letter from my primo, my cousin, Carlitos. I live in America, but he lives in Mexico, where my family is from. Maybe someday we'll meet. Dear Primo Charlie, how are you? Do you wonder, like me, what life is like far away? I live on a farm surrounded by mountains and trees. My family grows many things, such as maíz. So for those of you who speak Spanish, there's a lot of Spanish in this book. What does maíz mean? That's right, corn. And if you didn't know that word in Spanish, you could always look at the picture and say, oh, there's corn, and the word below is maíz. We have a burro, pollos, and a gallo. Every morning, the gallo crows and crows. A burro is a donkey, right here. Pollos are the chickens. And the gallo is the rooster. When he crows, he goes, cock-a-doodle-doo. Dear Primo Carlitos, I live in a city. From my window, I can see a bridge and cars zooming by. I can see skyscrapers, too. Skyscrapers are buildings so tall, they tickle the clouds. At night, all the lights from the city look like the stars from the sky. Take a second to think, does your home where you live look more like this? Or like where Carlitos lives? I know that where I live, it's kind of a mixture of the two. Every morning, I ride my bicicleta to school. I ride it past the Peros and past the Nopal. I ride the subway to school. The subway is like a long metal snake and it travels through tunnels underground. Does Federal Way have a subway? Nope, not yet. Although we're gonna get a light rail soon. That's like a small train that travels above ground, kind of like a subway, but not underground. At recess time, I play football. My friend passes me the ball, I kick it with my foot, and if I score, I yell, goal! I play basketball. My friend dribbles the ball and passes it to me. I jump and shoot. The ball goes swoosh, nothing but net. When I come home from school, I help my mom cook. My favorite meal is quesadillas. I make them with cheese and tortillas. In America, we have lots of different foods. My favorite is pizza. I like getting a slice on my way home from school. What kind of foods do you eat at home or in restaurants? I enjoy both of these foods. After I finish my homework, my mom lets me go outside and play. In Mexico, we have many games, like trompos and canicas. My favorite game is papalotes. My friends and I run and run, and with a little wind, we fly the papalote high up. So you can see, what is a papalote? A kite. And some of you may already know these words, and even more in Spanish. It's pretty cool. When I finish my homework, I play games with my friends from the building. We play by the stoop and in each other's apartments too. I like going over to my friend's home to play video games. This reminds me of recess. At Olympic View where I work, they have hopscotch too. And of course, jump ropes. So fun. In the afternoon, it often gets hot. To cool off, I jump in a small río that is nearby. What is a río? A river. That's how you say that word in English and Spanish. Río is river. In the summer, the city gets hot too. I like getting splashed by the fire hydrant when the firefighters open it up and close off the block. Different ways of playing in the water. On the weekend, I go with my parents to the mercado, an open-air market in the town nearby. We sell maíz and tunas, a prickly fruit that we grow. On the weekend, I go with my mom to the supermarket. She brings a list: milk, toothpaste, soap, and I check off the items as we put them in our cart. In the town, from time to time, they have fiestas that last 2 or 3 days. At night, there are cohetes that light up the sky and mariachis that play and play. In my city, sometimes we have parades. People in costumes and uniforms march down the street and everyone gathers around to watch. I spy a marching band and a mariachi band. They both involve costumes and sometimes horns. There are charros in Mexico that I wish you could see. They do tricks with their caballos and reatas. On the streets here, you can see breakdancers who do flips and spin on their heads. B-boys. And if you're a girl who breakdances, you're a B-girl. It's kind of like gymnasts mixed with dance. In Mexico, we have so many traditions, such as the Día de los Muertos, the Day of the Dead. My favorite tradition is attending the December parties called posadas. At the end of each posada, there is a piñata filled with fruit. When someone breaks it, we all get to jump in. That's a fun tradition, breaking open a piñata. In America, we have traditions too, such as Thanksgiving when we eat turkey, and Halloween when we dress up and go trick-or-treating. But I have to stop writing now. My mom just told me I have to brush my teeth and go to bed. Take a second to think about what traditions your family enjoys. Where do those traditions come from? Who do you celebrate them with? I have an idea. Okay, Carlito says, my primo should come visit me. And Charlie says, my primo should come visit me. They had the same idea. And that's the end. And then the author's note, it says that the author was born in Mexico City and grew up in Mexico. And then he moved to America. And I wonder if some of you who are watching this video now, if you came from a different country too, maybe a different state, different city, but it's really cool to share in different traditions or share different family connections. And I think this book does a really good job of doing that. All right, I'm going to stop this video and we are going to... All right, my face is back up on the screen and so is our book, our second book, Oh, the Places You'll Go by the one and only Dr. Seuss. Let's get started. I bet a bunch of you read this book before, but sometimes it's fun to reread books, read them again. Congratulations! Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own and you know what you know. and you are the guy who will decide where to go. You'll look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you will say, I don't choose to go there. With your head full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down any not so good street. And you may not find any you'll want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town. It's opener there in the wide open air. So colorful. Out there, things can happen and frequently do to people as brainy and footsy as you. And when things start to happen, don't worry, don't stew. Just go right along. You'll start happening too. Oh, the places you'll go. Such cool artwork. You'll be on your way up. You'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. You won't lag behind because you'll have the speed. You'll pass the whole gang and you'll soon take the lead. Wherever you fly, you'll be best of the best. Wherever you go, you will top all the rest. Except when you don't, because sometimes you won't. I'm sorry to say so, but sadly it's true that bang-ups and hang-ups can happen to you. You can get all hung up in a prickly perch, and your gang will fly on. You'll be left in a lurch. Avi's getting comfy in my lap. You'll come down from the lurch with an unpleasant bump, and the chances are then that you'll be in a slump. And when you're in a slump, you're not in for much fun. Unslumping yourself is not easily done. There's less bright colors on these pages. Seems like this friend is going through some bumpier times in its life. You will come to a place where the streets are not marked. Some windows are lighted, but mostly they're darked. A place you could sprain both your elbow and chin. Do you dare to stay out? Do you dare to go in? How much can you lose? How much can you win? And if you go in, should you turn left or right in 3/4, or maybe not quite, or go around back and sneak in from behind? Simple it's not, I'm afraid you will find, for a mind maker upper to make up his mind. You can get so confused that you'll start in to race down the long wiggled roads at a breakneckish pace, and grind on for miles across weirdish wild space, headed, I fear, toward a most useless place, the waiting place. For people just waiting. Waiting for a train to go, or a bus to come, or a plane to go, or the mail to come, or the rain to go, or the phone to ring, or the snow to snow, or waiting around for a yes or a no, or waiting for their hair to grow. Everyone is just waiting. Waiting for the fish to bite, or waiting for wind to fly a kite, or waiting around for Friday night, or waiting perhaps for their Uncle Jake, or a pot to boil, or a better break, or a string of pearls, or a pair of pants, or a wig with curls, or another chance. Everyone is just waiting. No, that's not for you. Somehow you'll escape all that waiting and staying. You'll find the bright places where boom bands are playing. That looks better. Brighter. Brighter. With banner flip-flapping, once more you'll ride high, ready for anything under the sky. Ready because you're that kind of a guy. Oh, the places you'll go, there is fun to be done. There are points to be scored, there are games to be won. And the magical things you can do with that ball will make you the winningest winner of all. Fame, you'll be famous as famous can be, with the whole wide world watching you win on TV. Except when they don't, because sometimes they won't. I'm afraid that sometimes you'll play lonely games too. Games you can't win because you'll play against you. Darker colors again. All alone. Whether you like it or not, alone will be something you'll be quite a lot. And when you're alone, there's a very good chance you'll meet things that scare you right out of your pants. There are some down the road between hither and yon that can scare you so much you won't want to go on. But on you will go though the weather be foul. On you will go though your enemies prowl. On you will go though the hackencracks howl. Onward up many a frightening creek though your arms may get sore and your sneakers may leak. On and on you will hike, and I know you'll hike far, and face up to your problems, whatever they are. And that was like a big problem. But he's being brief. He's like, hey, it's cool, I got this. Let me help you. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. So be sure when you step. Step with care and great tact, and remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains. Be your name Buxbaum or Bigsby or Bray or Mordecai Alley Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. And that was the end of Oh, the Places You'll Go, a very special book because it makes me think about all of you out there and all of the mountains you have ahead of you. And all of the wonderful things you're going to accomplish in your life. And I look forward to seeing all the places you guys go. And I'm really grateful to be a part of this journey as you move out from second grade into third grade. And I hope that the work we did was helpful to you and that it helps you move your very own mountains. Goodbye from Miss Frederick and of course from Javi too. Say goodbye, Javi. And we will see you later. Bye.
Miss Wagner here, teaching you second grade math. We're going to need the same materials, something to write on, something to write with, and have our stuffy. I know a lot of you probably already have it with you, but just in case, go get that stuff right now, and let's go ahead and get started. All right, friends, so just like we have talked about, we're going to be working on the same learning target. So remember that we're going to be able to explain if we're why we're adding or subtracting, and that we're using a strategy, right? And that we can explain and talk about our strategy as well. We've been doing this with story problems, and we're going to continue doing that today. So let's just read our learning target one more time. Ready? I will be able to explain why adding or subtracting works by using a strategy. And again, strategies that we've been talking about is open number lines, using our 10 blocks, 100 blocks as well, and the charts. All right, so today I'm going to kind of do a combination of two. I'm going to still do that chart, just kind of give you a review. Maybe you want to use that one today. And then I'm going to go ahead and show you the number line when using three digits. So maybe for just the warm-up today, we're going to go ahead and use the chart since we worked on that yesterday. All right, we have two problems right here. 452 minus 100, 121. 573 minus 321. Again, 452 minus 121 and 573 minus 321. If you don't want to use the chart, you don't have to if you have another strategy, but I'm going to use the chart for this for our warm-up. So go ahead and solve your two equations. About another minute. All right, friends, let's go ahead and look at the very first one, 452 minus 121. So I'm taking the bigger number, like always, and putting it first, 452 minus 121. All right, let's go ahead and subtract. Two, take away one is one. 5, take away 2, and you can do 5, take away 2, 3. And 4, take away 1, 3. So 452 minus 121 is 331. Nice job if you got that right. Hopefully use the chart for that. If you had another strategy, that's okay. All right, let's go ahead and look at this again. 573 minus 321, we're looking at the bigger number, 573 minus 321. All right, 3 take away 1, 2, 7 take away 2, 7 take away 2, 5 take away 3, 2. So we have 252, 4. That equals, 573 minus 321 equals 252. All right, friends, let's go ahead and get started. So I use the chart just to kind of remind you how to use the chart. If you want to use that today for your strategy, please go ahead if you feel comfortable. I am going to use a different strategy today, just kind of showing you as many ways as possible. All right. We're going to look at a story problem. Remember, when we're doing a story problem, we have three questions. Let's go ahead and read them together. Ready? What is the problem about? What are you trying to find out? What information is important? All right. We're going to be looking at the very first question for our first read. All right, ready to read it with me? Thinking about what is the problem about. Max scores 372 points in a computer game. Abby scores 481 points in the same game. How many fewer points does Max score than Abby? All right, go ahead and turn to your stuffy and tell your stuffy what is the problem. What is the problem about? All right, so hopefully you are all done telling your stuffy. So what is the problem about? The problem is about Max scores a certain amount on a computer game and Abby scores, 480 points on the computer game, and they want to know the difference between the scores. All right, let's go ahead and get ready to read it the second time. Thinking about what are you trying to find out? Are you ready? Max scores 372 points in a computer game. Abby scores 481 points in the same game. How many fewer points does Max score than Abby? What are you trying to find out? Go ahead and turn to your stuffy and answer that question. So, what are we trying to find out? How many fewer points does Max score than Abby? Right? It's always that question at the end. That's what we're trying to find out. That is our purpose of this math equation. All right, last question. What information is important? Ready? Let's read it our third time. Max scores 372 points in a computer game. Abby scores 481 points in the same game. How many fewer points does Max score than Abby? What information is important? Go ahead and talk about that with your stuffy right now. All right, so things that are important is that Max scores 372 points, right? That's important. And Abby scores 481 points. So there's our two numbers. But there's something in here that's also going to tell us if we're adding or subtracting. And this is kind of when we go into that explaining. So I want you to take a second, turn to your stuffy, and talk to your stuffy about, do you think we're going to add? Or do you think we're going to subtract? And how do you know? And there's probably a word in here that's going to tell you how you know. So I'm going to give you a couple seconds to go ahead and do that. All right, so I'm going to jump in. The word that stands out to me the most is the word fewer, fewer points. How many fewer points does Max have? Because Max has the smaller amount, right? And Abby has a larger amount. So we're trying to find out that number kind of in between. So how many fewer points does he have? So when I think of the word fewer, that's making me think of subtraction. So with that being said, our problem is going to say 481 minus 372, because we are going to be subtracting. This word right here gave that away. Hopefully you got the same thing. Now you have your equation right here. I want you to go ahead and solve your equation. And that again could be using that chart if that's what you want to do, a number line if that's what you want to do, or your blocks, or any other way that you know how to subtract. We've been focusing a lot on the chart, number line, and our blocks. So you choose what's best for you and go ahead and solve. About 20 seconds. All right. So we already talked about and explained why we are subtracting. Now let's go ahead and talk about the strategy that we used. So you're going to go turn to your stuffy. You're going to tell your stuffy the name of the strategy. And then you're going to go ahead and talk about step by step by step of how you solve this equation. So first I, next I, then I, finally I, go ahead and do that. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and show you the strategy I wanted to focus on today, which is this open number line, just to kind of give you some more skills and practices on your own. So we're looking at the open number line with three digits, a little bit more tricky, but I know you could do it. So I'm subtracting, so I'm going to be going down, right? We're taking away, so we're going down. We're not going to go up, we're going down. So our bigger number is 481. That's where we're going to start, and we're going to go down from there. I'm going to put 481 here. And now I'm going to break this number apart by hundreds, tens, and ones, just like what we do with double digits. But now we're working with three. So the hundreds, I have three hundreds. That means I'm going to go down 300. And it's just like 4 minus 3. And 4 minus 3 is 1. So that means I'm going to have 100. But I'm still having the digits right here. So 181. Okay. Now I'm looking at the 300. I did the hundreds. Now I'm going to look at the 10 spot. And what do I have? I have 7. So that means I have 7 tens. So that means I'm going down 70. But again, I'm really just looking at the 8 and the 7. And I'm thinking about, all right, 8 take away 7. What's 8 take away 7? 1, right? Which means now I have 100, 111. Because I'm just taking the 70 away from here. Now I'm looking and I see that I'm going to be taking away 2 ones. So I'm at 101, 110, 109. Let me go that 1, 2. So 110, 109. So let me go back and kind of just do this one more time. I had the bigger number, right? I looked at 372. I saw that I have 3 hundreds. So I took 481 and I took 300 away from that. And that's really, I'm just looking at the 4 and the 3. Like if I have 4 and I take away 3, I have 100. I'm still keeping these digits because I haven't done anything with them. So I have 181. Then I look at 372. I see I have 7 tens, which equals 70. So now I'm looking at 70, 8 minus this 80, right? That was 8. So I'm just really focused on 8, taking away 7, giving me 1. Again, just focusing on this part right here. That's how I got 111. I still kept the 1 because I haven't done anything with the 1 spot. So then I look over here and I have 2, 2 1s. So I'm going to go down 2 times. 1, 2. So 111, 110, 109. And that's how I got my answer. That's just one way you can do it. If you want to practice your number lines, I suggest that you do it. Just create 3-digit subtraction or 3-digit addition and go ahead and practice that. Again, if you have trouble creating those on your own, ask somebody. Ask an older sibling, a cousin, an aunt, a grandparent, or your parent, whoever you have around that you can, okay? And practice using an open number line. It's going to help you for third grade next year. All right, friends. I really enjoyed teaching you. I hope you had fun. Have a great rest of your summer.
Mrs. Mares, una vez más en nuestras lecciones de matemáticas, solo quiero recordarte que el día de hoy vamos a usar los mismos materiales que usamos todos los días, pero si quieres un recordatorio, necesitas un lápiz y papel para poder seguir la lección conmigo. Prepárate porque hoy vamos a restar. Como lo hicimos ayer que sumamos, hoy vamos a restar. Así que prepárate para nuestra historia de matemáticas con tu lápiz y tu papel. Comencemos nuestra lección. El día de hoy continuaremos con nuestro objetivo que hemos estado practicando toda esta semana. Y el objetivo dice así, solo para que te recuerdes y lo tengas en tu mente. ¿Podré explicar ¿por qué las estrategias de suma y resta funcionan? Eso quiere decir que hoy vamos a seguir practicando nuestra suma y nuestra resta, más que todo nuestra resta hoy, pero vamos a explicar por qué funciona la estrategia que usamos. Hoy vamos a seguir usando nuestros dibujos y nuestros bloques, así que tienes que tener tu papel y tu lápiz listo para poderlo hacer conmigo. Vamos a comenzar con nuestro calentamiento del día de hoy. En tu papel, escribe esta ecuación. La voy a leer dos veces para que tú tengas tiempo de escribirla. 573 menos, vamos a restar el día de hoy, menos 321. 573 menos 321. 573, lo leí una vez más, menos 321 es igual a, y todavía no sabemos. Así que, ¿estás listo? Vamos a comenzar a calentar nuestra mente y vamos a practicar cómo restar tres dígitos de tres dígitos. Así que primero tenemos que ver cuál es nuestras unidades, cuáles son nuestras decenas y cuáles son nuestras centenas. Me vas a ayudar y vamos a dibujar nuestras unidades, decenas y centenas para 573. Así que alista tu lápiz y lo vamos a dibujar juntos. 573 tiene ¿cuántas unidades? ¿Cuántas unidades tiene? Necesito que participes y lo puedes decir en voz alta, alguien que esté a la par tuya, a tu peluche, si tienes tu peluche listo, como tú quieras, pero participa conmigo para que lo podamos hacer juntos. 573, ¿cuántas unidades tiene 573? Tiene tres unidades, así que vamos a dibujar tres unidades. Uno, dos, tres. Muy bien. ¿Cuántas decenas tiene 573? ¿Cuántas decenas tiene? ¿Cuántas tiene? Tiene siete. Vamos a dibujar siete grupos de 10. Acuérdate que un grupo de 10 tiene 10 unidades, así que vamos a dibujar siete grupos de 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, se me fue un poco pando, 5, 6, 7, muy bien, tenemos 7 grupos de 10. Ahora, ¿cuántas centenas tiene 573? Dilo a alguien a la par tuya, a tu peluche, o lo puedes decir en voz alta, ¿cuántas centenas tiene? Tiene 5, 5 centenas, quiere decir que vamos a dibujar 5 grupos de 100. Tenemos que dibujar como un cuadrado porque eso me da 100, ¿verdad? Tenemos 10 grupos de 10 acá. Tenemos 10 grupos de 10. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 y 100. Así que tengo que dibujar 5 centenas. 1, 2, 3, 4 y 5. Muy bien, 5 centenas. Ahora tengo que restar, quiere decir menos, le voy a quitar. Así que comencemos con nuestras unidades. Quitémosle, ¿cuántas unidades le tengo que quitar? Le tengo que quitar una unidad. Adiós a una unidad. ¿Cuántas decenas le tengo que quitar? ¿Cuántas decenas? Dos. Uno, dos. ¿Y cuántas centenas le tengo que quitar? Tres. Adiós a las centenas. Dos, tres. Ahora contemos cuál es nuestro total. Contemos de 100 en 100, luego de 10 en 10 y luego de 1 por 1. ¿Listo? Cuenta conmigo. 100, 200, 210, 220, 230, 240, 250, 251, 252, 252. Y podemos ver que tengo dos centenas, cinco decenas y dos unidades. Así que mi respuesta es 252. Muy bien. Ahora, ¿cómo podemos saber que tenemos la respuesta correcta? Pues si te fijas en nuestros dibujos, si fuera y le quitara 325 o le sumara 321 a 252, me va a dar mi primer número, que fue 573, porque le quité 3, 2 y 1, y si le sumo eso, voy a tener lo mismo. Te lo puedo mostrar rápidamente para que veas que sí funciona lo que hemos hecho. Por ejemplo, si tengo 252 y le voy a sumar este número, pon atención a lo que voy a hacer para que veas que tenemos el número con cual comenzamos. Tengo 252. Si puedes ver, dibujé rápidamente dos centenas, cinco decenas y dos unidades. Ahora le voy a agregar 321. Tres centenas más, dos decenas más y una unidad más. Y si te fijas, tenemos el mismo número. 500, porque tengo centenas. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. Cinco centenas. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete decenas. Y tres unidades. Y si te fijas, tenemos el mismo número. Eso quiere decir que nuestra estrategia funcionó. Así que vamos a practicar esta estrategia en nuestra historia de matemáticas del día de hoy. Acuérdate que para nuestra historia siempre tenemos que preguntar tres cosas. ¿De qué se trata la historia? ¿Cuál es nuestra pregunta o qué tenemos que resolver? Porque siempre hay una pregunta. ¿Y cuál información es importante? Dile esas tres preguntas a tu peluche o a alguien que está a la par tuya. O si quieres, lo puedes decir en voz alta conmigo. ¿Listo? Vamos a decir las tres preguntas. ¿De qué se trata el problema o la historia? ¿Qué tengo que resolver? ¿Qué tengo que resolver? ¿Y qué información es importante? Leamos nuestra historia. Max obtiene 372 puntos en un juego de computadora. Abby obtiene, quiere decir que ella hizo esos puntos, 481 puntos en el mismo juego. ¿Cuántos puntos menos obtuvo Max en comparación de Abby? Primera pregunta, ¿de qué se trata esta historia? ¿De qué se trata esta historia? Díselo a tu peluche o a alguien que está a la par tuya. Dile de qué se trata esta historia o si quieres lo puedes decir en voz alta. ¿De qué se trata esta historia? Se trata de que Max y Abby están jugando un juego de computadora. Vamos a leerlo otra vez. Y la segunda pregunta es, ¿qué tenemos que resolver o cuál es nuestra pregunta? Max obtiene 372 puntos en un juego de computadora. Abby obtiene 481 puntos en el mismo juego. ¿Cuántos puntos menos obtuvo Max en comparación de Abby? ¿Cuál es nuestra pregunta? ¿La tienes en mente? ¿Cuál es nuestra pregunta? Nuestra pregunta es, ¿cuántos puntos menos obtuvo Max en comparación de Abby? Eso quiere decir que vamos a restar, porque tenemos que saber cuántos menos hizo Max, porque Max hizo 372 y Abby hizo 481. Así que tenemos que quitarle para saber cuántos menos hizo Max que Abby. Tercera pregunta, ¿qué información es importante? Ahora tenemos que saber qué información es importante. Max obtiene 372 puntos. Eso es importante. Y Abby obtiene 481 puntos. También lo importante es que tenemos que restar. Tenemos que quitar. Muy bien. Ahora vamos a escribir nuestra ecuación. Vamos a escribir la información importante, nuestra resta, y luego vamos a intentar de resolver. Así que nuestra información es que Max tiene 372 puntos y Abby 481. Y cuando estamos restando, recuerda que el número más grande tiene que ir primero. Así que vamos a poner cuánto tuvo Abby, porque acuérdate que ella tuvo más que Max y tenemos que saber cuánto menos, quiere decir que vamos a restar, tuvo Max, menos los puntos de Max. Y así vamos a enterarnos cuántos puntos menos tiene Max. Muy bien. Ahora vamos a resolver usando nuestros bloques. Pero primero tenemos que identificar nuestras unidades, nuestras decenas y también nuestras centenas. Muy bien. Ahora resolvamos. Acuérdate, alista tu lápiz y tu papel. Escribe esta ecuación conmigo. 481 menos 372 es igual a, y todavía no sabemos. Así que prepáralo conmigo. Muy bien. Vamos a comenzar a dibujar. Comencemos con 481. ¿Cuántas unidades tiene 481? Tiene una unidad. Recuerda de participar conmigo si se lo dices a tu peluche o a alguien que está a la par tuya, o si solo lo quieres decir en voz alta, lo puedes decir. ¿Cuántas decenas tiene 481? ¿Cuántas tiene? 8. Vamos a dibujar 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Dibújalas en tu papel. ¿Cuántas decenas tiene 481? Ya hicimos las decenas. ¿Cuántas centenas? ¿Cuántas tiene? Tiene 4. Vamos a dibujarlas. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ahora yo lo voy a hacer con otro color para que veas lo que le estoy quitando. Vamos a quitarle, porque estamos restando, quiere decir que le estamos quitando algo, 372. Aquí tengo dos unidades que tengo que quitar, pero no puedo porque solo tengo una. ¿Qué tengo que hacer? ¿Te recuerdas qué es lo que hicimos hace una semana? ¿Cuándo teníamos que quitar más de lo que teníamos? Creo que le pedimos a un grupo que si por favor se hacía unidades. ¿Te acuerdas cuál grupo es ese? El grupo de las decenas. Tenemos que decirle a un grupo, por favor, ¿te puedes convertir en 10 unidades? para así poder quitar 2. Ahora sí podemos restar, podemos quitar 2 unidades. Así que quitemos 2. 1, 2. ¿Cuántas decenas le tengo que quitar a 481? 7. Veamos si tenemos suficiente. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. ¡Wow! Le quitamos lo que le faltaba. 7. Así que le quitamos todas las decenas. Ahora veamos cuántas centenas le tenemos que quitar. Dile a alguien ahí en donde estás, en tu peluche, alguien a la par, o lo puedes decir en voz alta. ¿Cuántas centenas? 3. Vamos a quitar 3. 1, 2, 3. Ahora podemos ver cuál es nuestra respuesta. Tenemos 100. No tenemos decenas, pero sí tenemos unidades. Veamos cuántas unidades tenemos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Tengo 109. Tengo una decena, perdón, una centena. Siempre me confundo con las decenas y centenas. Una centena, 0 decenas y 9 unidades. Nuestra respuesta es 109. Ahora veamos cuál era nuestra pregunta. ¿Cuántos puntos menos obtuvo Max en comparación de Abby? Max obtuvo 109 puntos menos. Quiere decir que Abby hizo 109 puntos más que Max. Max hizo 109 puntos menos que Abby y por eso ella agarró 481 puntos. ¿Y cómo sabemos que nuestra suma o nuestra resta funciona? Porque acuérdate, ese es nuestro objetivo. Funciona porque le quitamos, porque eso es lo que nos decía nuestra pregunta, y también porque enseñamos que le quitamos a 481. Sigue practicando estas estrategias en tu casa. Puedes usar los bloques, la línea de números que hemos practicado todas estas semanas. Busca sumas y restas para practicar. Hasta luego.